it's about this character, Alice Kinney, and she is recently separated, moved from New York back to Los Angeles, her home. She has two little kids, and she just has no idea what the rest of her life is going to look like. And these three guys come and move into her guest house because they need some place to stay, and she ends up having a romance with one of them. Well, the movie is definitely a love letter to movies. It's about a girl whose father was a famous movie director, and obviously Hallie has had a great experience growing up on movie sets. It really is a magical life, and it's a wonderful thing to be a storyteller in this world. So it's treated with the kind of reverence that I think it deserves. Well, I really like that this character is a time in her life where she's trying to figure out what the next chapter is. You know, we have these long lives now, and sometimes something you decided at 25 doesn't necessarily work for your life when you're 40. So she's evaluating. She's recently separated. She's found a new love in this young guy, and she's trying to figure out what to do next.
Talking about time, obviously, it's such an exciting time, I think, for a strong feminine perspective in storytelling, particularly behind the camera. Can you talk about how special it was for you to be working with some very talented women on this specific project?
Yes, I mean, I learned a great deal from Nancy Meyers. She's just a real veteran. She understands comedy. She understands story and structure. And it was wonderful to get to sit with her and just side by side talk about what was next and how we would put this whole thing together. And it was a really great experience for me. There's a lot of bad news in the world, and this is just a movie that makes you feel good. People laugh. They love bringing their kids. They love bringing their parents. It's just, it's a feel-good movie. And I think we're all ready for a feel-good movie.
Well, this is a story of a woman who separates from her husband and moves to her hometown of Los Angeles, meets these three aspiring filmmakers, and they wind up moving in with her and her two daughters. So for me, you know, I love romantic comedies that have intertwined relationships. I loved Woody Allen movies where it would, you know, he'd be in love with her, who was married to him, who was dating her, who was the sister of this person. So for me, it was interesting to just bring all these people under one roof and see the dynamics that would sort of evolve from there.
Very much a love letter to films and LA. Can you talk about how much of that was autobiographical? How much of your own love for that world went into writing the script?
Yeah, well, you put so much of yourself in your writing, you know, and for me, I've been a cinephile my whole life. I love Hollywood, and I love the sort of 70s era of Hollywood in Los Angeles, and those kind of filmmakers like Hal Ashby and Peter Bogdanovich and Paul Mazursky. So for me, I wanted to infuse that into our story, and I think Los Angeles through reality TV has sort of gotten this bright, horrible look to it, and the LA that I love is, you know, warmly lit and Spanish homes and this kind of Hollywood oasis. So I wanted to portray that in the movie. You know, once Reese came on board, I knew I wanted a really experienced cinematographer because, you know, this was an independent film and low budget and a first-time filmmaker. So it was important for me to surround myself and her with experienced people. So that's why I called on Dean. Yeah.
Can you talk a little bit about the unique qualities that Reese has as a performer that made her right for this role and having people like Michael around her?
Yeah, well, you know, Reese is the perfect person for this part. I think I could have only dreamed as a first-time filmmaker that she would actually play this part because I think she's so relatable, she's very vulnerable, and she's also strong, and she's a terrific comedian. So she's really the full package. And Michael Sheen is terrific and hilarious, and I think this film actually shows a bit of a different side to him. He gets to be this kind of sexy cad, and that was a lot of fun. I hope they laugh and I hope they cry because I think that's the best way to receive a film. I think it's a feel-good movie. So
I would say that her story was classic and then kind of had the classic bones. Sorry, I have a romantic comedy, but it was also modern and a unique ending. And it was a fresh, modern story. And I like, in a way, that she didn't write. I have written about women my age from when I was her age till I got older. All my actresses kept... Oh, I keep hitting your mic. Sorry. All my actresses kept aging with me, and I stuck with them. But I thought it was really interesting that a 29-year-old was writing about a 40-year-old. Not that you have to write your own age, but I've happened to have done that. So I found that really cool. I like that there were kids in it that were interesting parts for children. They weren't just the kids that delivered the joke. So there's just everything about it. I love the subject matter. I was excited for her, and when she asked me to produce it, I said, yes, I will, and I've never done that before, you know, produce someone else's movie. you know, when I read it, she wasn't done, so she was looking for notes. So I gave her what I thought were notes. She took them or she didn't take them. You know, I didn't say, you must make her say this in this scene, you know, but I said, maybe it's a good idea if this happens about here or... So, and I ask a lot of questions of myself as a writer, so I asked her a lot of questions, you know. Why did she say this? But, you know, just thinking about all that prepares you to direct. Doesn't have to even show up in the script, but you have to know it. I think that most of us, at some point, are in a relationship with our father, or with our husband, or with our boyfriend, with our daughters, or our sons. You know, I don't write fantasies. I write people at home. Maybe I dial up what happens to them, because after all, you bought a ticket to see a movie. So I'm not going to show you exactly what happens in my living room. But it is all based on things I've lived through, or I understand, or I've seen my friends live through. So I just think relatability, and I think humor is a good calling card, you know. Well, what's great about Reese in this movie is that, you know, you don't always get the perfect person. So sometimes you are squeezing that square peg into your round hole of a movie, you know. This time we had the round peg. Oh, God, you guys, I'm so sorry. We had the round peg in the round hole. We had the right person for the right part, and that makes your day so lovely on set, because there was an easy communication. She looked the part. She felt the part. It resonated with her. She got divorced at a young age with little kids, and she got it, you know. She really understood it, and it made our lives so wonderful, really.
I'm the sort of, me and Reese's character are married, but we're sort of separated, and we're on different sides of the country, and the idea is that I'm maybe going to come out and we're going to maybe try again. We're not sure. But when I get there, Reese has sort of decided to move on, but I want things to get back together again, and she's now living with these three young guys, which I'm very, very upset about. And so whilst I'm there, I try and sort them out. Doesn't quite go to plan. I mean, the first thing was, it came from the mayor's stable. And, you know, I've been a great admirer of Nancy's work, and I think her films have such a distinctive quality to them, you know, and that says a lot about, for anyone to create their own kind of particular genre almost in film is a huge accomplishment. So for Nancy to have done that is amazing. I met Hallie, who, you know, first time filmmaker, so you're never quite sure how it's going to go, but she comes from great pedigree, great stock. And she seemed to know exactly what she wanted to do, and she had a lovely quality to her, and so I felt good about that. And, you know, when someone says, do you want to do a film with Reese Witherspoon? Kind of go, yeah, well, all right, yeah, I don't think I'm busy at the moment. So to be able to work with Reese as well was great. And I loved the story. I thought the story was really warm and compassionate and kind of loving about a family, a very unconventional family, but that's more and more the traditional version of things, I suppose. And I've gone through that kind of experience myself, so I like to see that story being told, and especially from a woman's point of view as well, which you don't get to see as often. And I like the fact that there's no real bad guy in it. I suppose I'm the closest thing to a bad guy, and I'm quite nice, you know, and I'm sort of forgiven at the end as well, and everyone's together at the end. So I like that. I thought it was a good message to get out there, and a nice sort of vibe to it.